Ok, levo cá. Actually, why scale like this is not my ideal ambition. And what I will do, because problem is not that you had cars, but problem is that a development is transport. Because any open source helps some hidden problems. So I will talk about some of the problems which makes me mad, and how I deal with them. So what problems make me mad? It's English mismatch, it's asynchronous programming, and compare. Let's start with some anti-pattern. It's configure runtime behavior creates. It's widely used anti-pattern. It exists in MongoDB and in standard Scala library. First example. Let we work with popular MongoDB database, and let we in one file made custom context, and in other file we then we will receive the doc in runtime. Oh, how great! How now you know why that is written in. What to do? The first maybe idea is don't use such libraries. I'm going to try. Let's start again. Example is not compatible with my motivation for proposing undated imports procedure. I wrote this in 220, patched compiler and Scala documentation generator, and wrote this bar. Idea was next. Let me allow import have accepted annotations. Then you can pop imports into a separate box and use such blocks. So we can have composable indices, and any sufficient one set framework will contain one import. Give me and my configuration. And in our example with MongoDB, file R and file B will have Y import. And this effectively can eliminate such type of errors. Oh. But unfortunately, it was too big change for Java because it was not sexy, it was an engineering problem, it was a simple problem. It was without monads, without effects, it seemed just simple. Before starting task inside feature, and we can receive this model is available on GitHub. I wrote it maybe from version 0.2. It will be available on Maven Central. What we noted is at the fork, and the option to start this agent when the button. And therefore, I will be able to see full traces, but only in the pandemic. And what we have? We have all stack trace which was called before is here, and stack trace which started from mine is here. Okay. What's other problem in the future? Problem that structure is very low load the phase. It's like manual memory management in C. For example, What we must do to retrieve data from SQL in Apta? You must configure SQL context, spawn from Apta fetch in this context, then Apta will run query and retrieve the data. Yes? And then pass SQL data to some place where this data can be handled again. I want to retrieve data. I must do four steps instead of one, which is my here. Why I must think about this? And somebody tell me that sleek future Apta patterns is a great interface. When they require me to do four steps instead of one. Oh, exist pattern in theory. Exist pattern interface. It's async. Or maybe who know what is async. Oh, not bad. So it's C22, which transform order with async to state machine. One of small example, it's from traditional documents. It's we can, in async, we can use await. And wrapping over in await things which give now futures. Then macro will transform this to some complex function which state a machine inside, which will now provide fetch. And it's great, it's normal fetch level interface at first. Problem that I think is second side citizen in Scala world. The first, we still have no second support, but and we have no technical reasons for upset exceptions. It's just nobody interested in this because we have no monad, we have no fetch, it's not fancy, yes, and trivial stack transform for exceptions is very not a decent task, yeah? We have no support for hash level functions. This is a technical issue. We will speak about this later. It's still steep, so we have no version 1 yet. And very often when I try to expose async interface, I see macros or compiler bug. When compiler can compile something forever or source the workflow. Can we do something with this? Yes. Maybe somebody of you who are in Kiev community knowing that I work with Port libraries which do CSP model processing or for these channels like Go and in Scala. And we can work around the same. And at first we can simply try catch that by defer. Defer is a very clever construct. It's maybe only one good construct in Go language. No, yes, it's a really good construct. No, it's sorry that it is in good language, but it is very good. Why is it good? Because it allows to compose defects. Because, for example, with try catch, I must use a try inside try and then try inside catch. Instead, I can write defects immediately after create the source of the field. And maybe assertive, the same construction in there is named scope, except in media, which it's what we can do when SIM is not support dry catch yet. Catch level function support. Let's look on next coder. For E12E, yeah, await the level sound. This is impossible, and we are trailing through how it's possible. Now we must write something loop by hand. This can be solved. How we can, before generation of async, wrap type classes for well-known high-order functions. For example, map algorithm device, the map async, which will accept future one. And this, and if you will allow developers to write on classes, then I think then for some time, any standard class will be wrapped such a way. And when testing the angle, which will give us full ISP for client library, then we try to generate a simple variant in simple case automatically. It's great in theory, but there is a problem. So we want a thing to be particularly compiler. But the thing is very low level interface. It's like automatic management in C++. Because harsh level way and real way is to have effects in type systems. In ideal world, we must just use scope, yes, and 2 seconds statements must compose the effects. And not hard last. No, in practice we know that when we stack on set of statements, we do that. If we have effects and a bit specialized context by effects, then maybe in general many problems with the C programming will go away. And I think that automatic execution flow management is the next step after automatic memory management, which must be done and yet not be done in this column. Let's maybe think on more from this point of view. Let's look on DAO, which work as we have assembler level, then C, then Java, then we have Scala, then some high level language like US Query, and then we have all high for the basics. Yes? Here it is possible to have a look at code, where on high level it's impossible. And in high level DFM, we have very big on-time comps. And the problem that Scala have no very big place in this tower. Because sometimes we need to be low level and we have no chances not use something like Scala. Sometimes we will high level. To illustrate how high level differ from low level Scala, let's look on fixed pattern. Here is fixed pattern written in Q language. I start today write automatically analog on Scala, but I was asleep. It will be 4-3. So we need split, then after the second, then for one, then that bit again to forget you. It's like 3. So like high level, that means a really high level. And the color is both of them quite stylized. And they exist in for you well-defined subject. But let's think, maybe we want to build new language on Scala. We have ESS here. Again, it's just set of problems which I have. We have very interesting set of types in global. We have no way to set precedence, manual construction. So it is possible, but when you write DSL, you think not about DSL, you think about how to pass Java Scala limits. And how to tell compiler that it must eat one. I can maybe show one example in just for one moment. Not for a minute. For example, Fibonacci fold. Here is 20 seconds. What's the thing? Yes. And here is a select which mimic select function in Go. And it was a very awkward things to do to tell Scala compiler that this is normal code. For example, what is white here? It's type. So it's part of a machine by type. Of course, it's possible to write code which transform language in such a way, but this is very, very awkward. So, I can say that Scala is one of my favorite languages. It can be something better. And this is maybe not problem in Scala, but problem that any something advanced development, consulted and harmful in some way. If you have questions or ideas, call me. Thanks for attention. Nobody have questions? Yeah, because we have six live talks. And maybe let's do start live talk. So few minutes. The first, let's try so the first will be it's because we have like talked about subscribe language, but I can see yes. The first we talk about subscribe language, then we have ethics sourcing by Daniel Goldman. How it works so much. Thomas Gabber. Oh, we have three talks from Thomas Gabber. Great. So it will be short. Then we have 10 minutes from the blog. And again, open cover. Okay.